Joining us now is John Heinberg, Senior Market Advisor with Stewart Peterson. John, thanks for joining us this morning.
Good morning, Robert.
Hey, we will start with the grain markets. How are they looking bright and early on this Wednesday morning?
Well, we had a pretty choppy overnight session. We got a 9 cent trading range in corn from high to low. Currently, though, grain price seeing a little bit of pressure. Corn down 3 to 5, beans down 2 to 3, wheat down 3 to 4.
And the latest crop report, corn looking good, soybeans looking good. Overall, the crops are looking pretty good. What are some things to look at that could impact that as we head through the next couple of weeks?
Well, obviously, we're getting to the key pollination stage here on corn, so weather conditions have been very favorable in that regard. That's where we're seeing a lot of the selling pressure here, as some of those long bets that people were making in the market with the wetness kind of ran to the sideline, bringing this to sharp pullbacks. So now we got to kind of see if this kind of holds. Can we continue to see some timely rains in some key areas? Those areas that are a little wet are kind of starting to dry out a little bit. But, you know, the question is how much damage is done in the corn crop. Same thing in the beans. Beans being a little more resilient-type plant, they can kind of pull through this a little bit. Still not probably going to get top-end yields, but we're still looking at some yields there. So these next 2 months in terms of corn and beans, the weather's going to be key as we're starting to get that pollination and pod-filling time. So if we get any adverse weather in there, we could get that risk premium coming right back in.
Now we're wrapping up July, heading on into August, wrapping up the barbecue season coming up here in a couple of weeks. How are the livestock markets looking?
Yeah, that's a big key. What you just kind of mentioned there is going to be the retail demand. We've seen those cattle retail prices really tumble the last few weeks here, and that's brought that those futures prices right with them. Market's a little bit oversold, had a nice bounce yesterday, maybe a short cover and rally. We'll have to see. Retail's firmed up nicely on Monday going into Tuesday, so that helped out a little bit. With that could get those cash prices to calm down again since they've dropped so dramatically as well. Hogs, kind of the same situation. We need to continue to see that demand pace for that retail product stay there. Hog prices kind of still at the bottom end of the trading range. Maybe we get a little push here as we move into fall.
It seems like the world markets are calming down just a little bit after some turmoil. Do you think that's going to stay the same? And if so, either way, how do you think that's going to affect livestock, the grain markets, and the commodities markets for that matter?
Well, like we saw on Monday, we're continuing to be concerned regarding the Chinese economy, seeing some economic data that's questionable. Then you got their stock market really taking some pretty good tumbles, putting in its worst day in basically almost a decade on Monday. And that really kind of helped as a commodity as a whole type basis. Got some risk-off trade. It's been very difficult now to find things that are moving in the positive direction, from gold to oil to the grains. It really comes into play when you got the world's largest customer got some questions regarding their buying power.
All right.
So we'll have to see that going forward.
All right. John, thanks for joining us this morning.
Thanks, Robert. Have a great day.
Hey, you too. All right, once again, that was John Heinberg, Senior Market Advisor with Stewart Peterson. Stay with us. One last look at your weather coming up right after the break, as well as a sneak peek at what's coming up next on The Valley Today.